Let's program some stupid stuff. So we're going to make the Guilfoyles Bitcoin warning system in Python. For those of you who have no idea what it's all about, well, let's put it simply. We're going to make a program that will be taking information from online about current Bitcoin values. It will be doing this ever so often. Afterwards, it will produce an audio alert for us if Bitcoin will drop below a certain threshold. That's pretty much it. The notification sound that we'll be using is a song by Napalm Death, You Suffer. However, for our case, to avoid any possibilities of being copyrighted, we'll be using a cover by Opeth. Okay, actually enough talk, let's program. Open your favorite text editor or any software you use to work with Python and we can start. For our case, we'll be using Visual Studio Code, but any software will work. First, we need to make a couple of functions. First one will be checking information online for Bitcoin value at the moment. CoinDesk has a very friendly API allowing us to do that, without any need to scrape the web page for anything. 6 lines of code, and you're done. Next, we'll create a function to play the alarm whenever we desire. Preferably, the sound clip should be also located in the same directory with your project file. Technically, by this moment, we're pretty much done. These functions are enough to add to a loop and add a few more conditions to make a working program. So let's do it. A few things we need to notice. The particular website that we are using and their API updates only every minute. Therefore, our value for the coin will also be updating every minute. Therefore, we need a pause between each check. And since we will be running our program in a loop, depending for how long we want it to run, we might as well make a function that stores our retrieved information in a log file and outputs a graph to visualize how our currency fluctuates. For the instance that I'm showing, the program will clear the log file every time it's being run. So if you want a continuously updatable one, you will have to make few adjustments to the code. Finally, we can patch it all up to be able to run this Bitcoin monstrosity from our folder without opening any text editing files every single time. In addition, we can create a settings text file that will hold some kind of presets that will be read every single time our program runs. Those presets will be quite simple. What currency we want to work with? For how many loops do we want to run our software? Well, basically for how many minutes? And what's the threshold beyond which, if the Bitcoin falls, we want to hear an alarm play? And that's kind of it. It's done. So let's run one example. So I'll choose the currency to be United States dollars, the threshold of $7,000, and I will want my program to run for 5 minutes. Now, if the Bitcoin is lower than $7,000, it will play an alarm. Let's check. There you go, a very simple program that you can run in your background to scare the living shit out of you every single minute of your life. Next time, how to build a hot dog not hot dog classifier. I post only once every 3 years, so maybe there will be something. Show support. See you next time.